Scandalous.
You can't touch me. I'm ripping it, taking over the country.
Scandalous.
You gotta love me. I'm flipping it, representing Andy.
Scandalous.
You gotta feel me. Tip your cup and get with me.
Scandalous.
If you don't see me, best believe you're gonna hear me. For me, it's not a mental challenge, I just like to bust. I'm serious, a message to cats, stop fearing us. We fabulous, we're coming through with rhymes so glamorous.
I put it up to dance and everything else I do. There's this effect unit that you had on the mixer. I could change the lights, but you showed me to prepare different looks.
Yeah.
So I could flip. Bro, this guy never looked like a rock star like that. I don't even, if we've got the footage of that stuff.
I've got some of that footage around.
Wow.
So much of that stuff around.
What is your most memorable moment, you think, when you came to working on events? Was there one event that you felt like, fuck?
Yeah, there were lots. I mean, you know, it's just a long thing. But that is part of life that's gone. I want to hear about your seven pillars. That's what I want to hear about.
So basically, I went and studied. I wanted to know more about wellness, and I knew wellness, so it wasn't just about going to the gym, pumping iron. I knew there was more, because when I learned about the nutrition, I realized that just by eating different and training different, you could change everything. And also then, when you're able to master your body, you were mastering a part of your mind. And I started realizing that goals and certain things mattered, but then the more aware you become, the more things start diversifying. So I found myself studying the seven dimensions of wellness, which basically cover every area of wellness that a human being needs to be at in order to be sort of well. So for example, I hope I don't forget anyone, but I'll remember it eventually. There's physical wellness, and of course taking care of the body, natural stuff like that, eating, nutrition, emotional wellness, because you're not emotionally well, you know.
Fuck.
It's just as important, not like physical is more important than emotional. And there's intellectual wellness. If you're not intellectually well, yeah.
Intellectual.
As far as what you know,
the world's not well, my brother.
Exactly. And knowledge is power, right?
Right?
If someone doesn't know, do you know they don't know that knowledge is power? So,
so intellectual, we're not shaping up too well.
So, but still,
as a species,
yeah.
Intellectual, we got problems. We got an area to work
let's
on.
Just say let's just say we're all at one level. We're at a certain
we're
level.
All on the same level intellectually. My God.
No, we're not at the same level. We're all at some part of the wheel.
Okay.
We're all some part of the same wheel.
So intellectual wells, you've got the physical, the emotional, and intellectual. Right?
Okay, so intellectual. Then you've got work, what's it called? Occupational work.
Occupational.
If you're not happy, work.
Then well, she's fucker.
You spend most of your time at work. You know what I'm saying? So if you're not doing something,
well,
that you...
people that are working spend most of their time at work.
Yeah.
At the moment,
but if you
COVID, is destroying the world. But
so,
also, so COVID destroys occupational.
So
workers,
yeah.
Right?
So we actually happen to be.
So COVID is turning around and screwed us on physical, emotional, intellectual.
We're not there completely.
And occupational.
So
let's
look at everything.
Right,
so then, after that, we've got social ones. Because a human being also needs to be social.
Yeah.
So you see already where everything is, how this thing has affected everything.
I want to cut my fucking wrists.
So everyone else...
That's five. It's still two.
Yeah, but everyone is feeling these things.
Seven
but now we actually...
Sins.
Seven deadly sins. But
give
now
me the last two.
So the last two are environmental ones.
Fuck! Help!
But the birds are singing in certain places where they weren't.
Okay. COVID. It's okay. I'm exactly.
So,
hey.
COVID, good or bad? I'm not like.
Yeah, exactly. No. Singing.
Number seven. Spiritual wellness.
Spiritual. So where are we actually healthy?
Each person is in a different.
No,
space.
No. Let's forget about people. Let's talk about.
Okay,
so species.
Let's go to physical. Let's break each one of them down.
Okay, oh. Physical, we're good. We're pretty, as a species, well, we're good,
yeah.
That we can be healthy if you've got money and you can eat well, you can be healthy. But if you're poverty-stricken,
exactly. So are we physically?
You're susceptible to disease, you're susceptible to malnutrition.
So you're saying if the economic, if the
so,
social wellness, if that occupational wellness is affected.
Occupational
you see
wellness
how one
is
thing,
affecting, yes, exactly.
Okay, so you see how everything's connected. Okay, so.
So physical wellness. we're saying okay, we've got physical wellness, we can say we've got the ability.
So let's break it down.
Maintain physical wellness,
so,
but at the moment it is elitist.
Right.
But,
and here's the importance of physical wellness.
One for the 1%, when, zero for 99% in the cup.
That's it. When we are physically well, it affects everything. Everything is done at another level.
Yeah. I'm with you. I'm just trying to look at the bigger picture at the moment.
So emotional wellness.
Emotional wellness. Divorce rates, abortion, politics, Trump.
Abuse,
Trump. Pedophilia, Trump. No, I suppose it's the other one. Eh? But all of the emotional wellness, why is there so much high divorce? Why is there such conflict in business? Why is there such conflict in families? Why is there such conflict in nations? Why is there such conflict in religion? They're all related to emotional instability or unwellness. And why is that? Tolerance, there's a whole lot of things.
Well, maybe people are just not, they're so constantly looking back what's happened and not being here right now. That all those past pains are still controlling.
Or they're turning around instead of looking back, just looking around.
Well, they're looking too far forward. So fearing for what's coming.
They're not walking their path. They're turning around looking what's happening in Istanbul and this kind of, I'm guilty of that.
So check this out. Where are you right now?
Where am I? I am sitting here with Casanova, my brother. Here in Rand Park, where do you wear masks? He's talking, obviously.
Just basics. Where are you?
Where am I?
Just basic. You're here.
Yeah.
And this
good space, huh?
You are always here. Mm-hmm. And only being here are you fucking awakened in the moment and able to almost like maneuver the matrix to your advantage. Because there's a certain amount of awareness. And put it this way. As someone that worked in boxing and stuff, the more aware the fighter is, the more you can protect yourself and counter and understand what's going on around you. By being aware, the more aware you are, the more present you are in the moment, in all your senses, the more you are able to respond to anything that happens, the better you are. If you're not seeing something, calm it down. So by being able to have the abilities,
it's awareness.
Peripheral, just awareness. Not good, bad, just awareness. Mm-hmm. Okay. So, physical wellness, you've got emotional wellness.
But emotional wellness, we still agree that we're not in a good space. And how do you turn
around? But yet there are some that are, because when you know how to, there is a way to get into a good space. And
The world is coming, they're coming to get the fucking house, the kids are freaking out, the schools are closed, the country's falling apart, the government's falling apart, the nation is fighting at each other's throats.
Yeah.
How the fuck are you supposed to be emotional?
Stand up and you've got to be a fucking warrior. This is how you've got to teach. You've got to make peace with what comes from behind. Because we're so controlled by everything that happened before and our perception of who we are. But we forget that we are looking with the eyes of, not to say children are bad, but eyes of a child with ignorance. We look at everything and that's what we base, like you said, that's a dog, that's a this, that's this. This is what we've... terms we've come up with.
The world we look at, okay? We look at the politicians that are supposed to be leading us, corrupt. Okay. We look at the law courts favoring the rich, okay? We're told to be honorable, and people acting dishonorable turn around and do good, and the people that are cool are suffering. We, the NGOs, will be away. You play a straight game and you get fucked up the ass.
Exactly.
That is what life is. So we're sitting in this whole paradoxical society. On Monday to Friday, we tear each other's throats out, whether it be metaphorically in the workplace or physically on a war front.
Yeah.
And then on Saturday and Sunday, we go to church depending on our conviction.
We pray and we
give charity, which actually feeds the people that the wars are destroying. And we live in this paradox, so we are all fucked up, but we're not learning history anymore. We've got the internet, great, so we can surf all over the place.
But what are we looking for?
Anywhere. Yes, we don't know what we're looking for. Instant gratification. We're looking for 6 seconds of glory. We're looking to go and find entertainment, escapism, or personal development. There's no philosophy, there's no history, no geography. These people putting these fucking statues down. Think about it, my brother. Do you think from the beginning of time, we can see statues back to 10,000 years? There's artifacts, monuments, old ruins and stuff, okay? Before 10,000 years ago, there's nothing. But meanwhile, conservative estimates say that humanity has been around for 300,000 years. But they found artifacts from 3 million years ago. Yes. Can you imagine how many dumb fucks have broken statues and buildings down over the last 3 million years, and then we sit here and we're guessing what our fucking history is? We would have known as two generations time they won't know that fucking slave traders existed. Yeah, because all the statues are gone, my friend.
Can't you fuck them shit? No, we don't know what happened.
We don't know what the fuck. Hey, what happened before? There was slave trade. Prove it. No, so, there's no statues. Good fuck.
Yeah, what you said is cool. Yeah. Because
and the history books out. You know why? Because people start like fucking virgins. We can turn around and manipulate people's thought process because we learn from experience.
So you keep that truth to yourself.
You remove the experience from people's memories and you can treat them like asses again. You can fucking...
Because they don't know each other. They don't know who they really are.
They don't know. They don't know where they come from. Faith. You got to have faith. And they turn around and we go back into the same shit. And we do the same stuff over and over,
yeah.
And we wonder why the disparity between the 1% and the 99% grows. Because the 1% say shit, and we say what color.
And so thank God, sometimes there's rebels with causes that have nothing to make from spitting truth or what they perceive as truth. Not going to hurt or harm, otherwise it's been authentic.
Yeah.
Like, Kevin's coming from a perspective, obviously, like, his perspective. Mine is, like, I feel like I have the key. I feel like I don't know it all, not at all. I'm not saying I know it all, but I am. It's amazing as it's unfolding. And I'm just talking. I want to talk about things that are working for me or have worked in my limited time.
Mm-hmm.
I do realize that we are all special, but none of us are special at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
No one more special than the other. We just got our own experiences, and someone will either get from it or not. So we're talking about wellness.
Yeah.
And these are the things that I had to go to in order to be well, because I went through some fucked up shit, you know?
No.
I went through as soon as you're going to really get there and go to the next level, you almost self-destruct consistently. Yeah. We were talking about this.
Yeah.
Until the point that you realize, shit, I've been the only person in my way based on the fact that I've been making assumptions about what everyone's been thinking about me. All these...
You know what you do? You know what I did? That I came back, you fucked up, okay? And all of a sudden, hey, you know, the two of us used to explode. Well, I used to explode, my brother. You know what I mean?
Yes.
And then all of a sudden, people don't want shit in their life. You know, they don't want to have other people's cuck in their heads. So the minute you do that, you turn around, you got shit, and you advertise
this.
It's like fucking COVID is bad, my brother.
Yeah.
Negativity or anger is 10 times worse. It's worse than
everyone is trying to get over it.
And people come fucking get. So then what you do is, how do you respond? You start acting like a cunt so that people, you can justify to yourself why people dislike you, because you don't want to think that they dislike you because of a failure.
Yes.
So you're acting like an idiot so that when people do already move away and not coming into your space, you can say, yeah, well, yeah, I caused it.
But also it's like...
It helps the hurt.
There's another side to that.
But self-destructive, obviously.
Yeah. There's something important I want to say, because you said we either fuck up because we created an anger, also because sometimes we're just making assumptions because of our mental play. What are we thinking about?
Bro, we turned around. We spoke earlier about self-esteem, and I said the most important consideration in aspirations for success is serious and honest assessment of your own self-esteem. Because if you've got a low self-esteem, you advertise it. And you advertise it most times by projecting superiority. People with healthy self-esteem
don't
turn around and try and look great. They don't turn around and
just dominate.
They just don't give a fuck if they are or not. They're just cool. They're fine with themselves.
Yeah.
So it's the acceptance of self. But we turn around and like the joke of the rabbit, man. Like I told you my joke, the rabbit and the fox.
Is it a dad joke? Is it
like Mr. Rabbit, he wants to go and he comes outside and he says, I love you, man. And he wants to mow his lawn. But he hasn't got a lawnmower. Mr. Fox has got a lawnmower. So he says, well, hey, I'm going to go to Mr. Fox, borrow his lawnmower, come on. Halfway there, he stops. Hey, Mr. Fox can be a sneaky bugger at times, eh? What happens if he doesn't let me go? Nah, he will. Gaze on just before he says, fucking Fox. If he doesn't end it all, I've helped him before. You fucking better let
him go. He's this whole story.
And he gets to the door. He opens, knocks on the door. Mr. Fox up and says, hello, Mr. Rabbit. How are you? He says, fuck you and your lawnmower. And that's the story. We turn around and we respond to what we assume the reaction is going to be. Before. And this is in the workplace, in relationships. We turn around, bullshit. And it comes and from comes lies to
self-perception.
And self-esteem. You know? You're saying, in other words, you want to be successful. First of all, look at yourself. If there are problems with yourself, fix them.
Yes, yes.
Have a look at them. Stand outside yourself and look at your reaction. Take a conversation, stand outside and look. And assess that thing and fix it. And eventually, when you fix it, or if you're cool, accept you're cool and you do not have to tap dance to anyone's tune.
Just say,
hey, you don't have to do that. It's your call, your opinion. When people like it or they don't like it, you're doing your fucking best. No one gets up in the morning.
But meanwhile, we're our own enemy because we like making these assumptions. This person thinks that.
Also,
everyone's got their own shit.
You show me a person. You show me a person that gets up in the morning and thinks, fuck, today I'm going to fuck up. No one gets up like that. We get up and we fuck up. Shit happens. You know what I mean? So someone else fucks up and we get up and we immediately get freaked out because we think that person got out of bed with the sole purpose of fucking me around.
Take it personally. Don't take things personally because it's another fucker. We take things personally.
And that's, again, self-esteem.
Because why do we feel like, you know, why... The thing that's happening is happening on its own. But we take things personally. We make assumptions. You know, then we end up talking shit to ourselves. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, can't you fuck? Oh, Mr. Fox fucked up.
Exactly.
And then you're creating a whole story.
And because what you're trying to project, who the fuck are you? But, so, first of all, work is who you are.
The truth
you
is beyond all of it. So, the truth just is. It's like, it's cool.
Yeah.
It's actually cool when you see it because you don't start sitting.
You don't have to live up to anyone's expectations. You've just got to amuse yourself. And that's what it is. It's got to amuse yourself. Life is about amusing yourself, it's about being happy.
How much time are you going to? Are you wasting time on?
No.
Like, you don't know when your ticket's out here. You bought your ticket with, like,
don't be an idiot. I mean, don't walk around. It's not like, hey, like, it's not the age of Aquarius, what it is actually. But it's not, that's not the deal. The deal is don't be a fucking dumb fuck. You know what I mean? Go out, do shit.
And do it.
Work out how you can live off of it, how you can make money out of it, how you can be cool with people, and how you can build a life. But so, the thing that kills them is fear, inactivity, paralysis, and not having a plan. Being successful is easy, bro. There's 5 steps as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah.
First of all, you've got to think of an idea. You've got to come up with some kind of thing. Then you've got to work out, is it doable at all? Can it be done? Third thing is, can you do it, or could you have organized that it gets done? For the next time, make some plans. Plan how to do it and put the plan in place. Next one, stop. And the final one, which guarantees success, don't stop until it's done.
That's in many ways how I was ready to come to you and give you a first product. It wasn't based on the other grand idea.
I'm trying to raise money.
We come together with our strengths, and then and those are the awakenings about just get up, feel it, and move on. You gotta love me. I'm flipping it, representing Andy. You gotta feel me. Tip your cup and get with me. If you don't see me, best believe you're gonna hear me. Fabulous ways, when music take you away. Feel free with the speed flow, is like a freeway flow. Right.